Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play Bloodborne. As you can see, I have a different character on. This is one I started up a couple weeks ago, just for fun. Well, good thing, because it came in use. Since I lost my recording for the second half of The Forbidden Woods, I just thought I'd take a crack at him with this guy. Anyway, the second half of The Forbidden Woods has snakes, and a lot of them. Their bite obviously is poisonous, so it's always handy to save a few antidotes for this level. Sometimes it's hard to see our little balls of snakes here, with this tall grass. But not too hard. Be on your guard. These guys tend to drop twin bloodstone shards, or poison bloodstone gems with poison added on. Let's see. Coming up here, we have an executioner. I wonder if we can sneak behind him. I've never tried that. Ah, it does work. Ah, that's all she wrote. But we had a couple of twin shards and some blood vials. Now, if I can aim just right. Aha! One attack. Now, these, with a faster weapon like the saw cleaver, saw spear, even the tinnitus is good for this. As long as you have a reasonably fast weapon, you know, you can beat these little collections of snakes without having to worry about them hitting you. Oh. You're supposed to be able to parry their grab attack, but I parried it just as he was grabbing me, so it didn't work out. But anyway, as I was saying, yeah, with a fast enough weapon, you can destroy the balls of snakes before they can even get a hit out on you. Which is nice. The tinnitus is kind of a maybe. It works most of the time, but it once in a while it'll flub and you'll get a snake in the face. I never realized how parryable these snakehead guys are. Always was a pain to beat them before, but you never know. Like that hurts. And every snakehead in that pile of snakes is deadly, well, and can do damage. So, although that one hit didn't do too much damage, they can do a lot if they put their mind to it. Now these are the big guys. They spit poison at you. The Snakers is pretty handy for them. They'll drop usually better bloodstone. Not better bloodstone shards. Better gems then the smaller bundles of snakes. And I think they've dropped the next tier of upgrade material for me also. But I'm not too certain. Oh, either way. Oh, I missed you. Yeah, the second half of the Forbidden Woods can be kinda confusing. Trying to get your bearings and everything can be a tad difficult here. Let's see, where am I? Is it? No. I'm looking for something. I can't seem to find it. I didn't want snakes, but... And I'm back on the start. Right. There's a particular ledge I'm looking for. And it's not that. Oh, no, it is. It's this ledge. Collect this item, though. Little twin shards, good. Snakes, not so good. Ah, poison, even worse. Alright, go. We jump. And it's a shortcut. It's a handy dandy, really, really well hidden shortcut to get the Braveguard mask. And the corresponding Graveguard sit. Let's see. Examining the robes. Robes of Doras, Graveguard of the Forbidden Woods. Countless bloody ritual tools hang from its back. Willem kept two loyal servants back at Bergenworth. When they were sent to the labyrinth, they encountered the Eldritch Truth and went mad. One became the password gatekeeper, while Dorez became a Graveguard of the Forest. Both remained loyal, even in madness. Yep, and we've met the Password Guardian. He's a little dead. And obviously Dorez is too. Since, well, that's obviously his robes. Ah, piggy. Voila. Oh, it's slightly gross, but also kind of funny is the fact that you can basically visceral attack a pig from the back. Ah, so funny. But yeah. And using this slot would have been the easier way to get to the Graveguard set, but yeah, the mask, you have to go to the upper ledge. Ah, here we go. Yeah, some of these guys... Some of the snakehead guys will whistle, summoning... small bundles of snakes. And if you are caught in the middle of the snake bundles, then you are a goner, because they strike you. Because if you think having one set of snakes strike at you is bad enough, having several gives you, one, no room to roll away, usually, and nowhere to, and you take damage so fast you can't even replenish it. And there's another pig. But we're going to avoid that piggy. We'll come this way. And hang a right. Yep. Hanging a right. We come up here. Avoid the grab of the snake man. Take that hit. Haha, more blood vials. Yay. What? We come up here. And we're back at the start of the second half of the Forbidden Woods. It's a rather useless shortcut. In a way, since the boss isn't that hard, so you really don't need to run back and forth. You know, run back and try to, you know, unless you find it hard. Oh no. On just a simple new game, I don't find this boss particularly hard, but after New Game Plus, on New Game Plus and afterwards, oh boy, is this boss a doozy. Although, the same can be said in any capacity to any of the other bosses. So, to each their own. Oh, we come up here. Thanks to Madman's knowledge and aliens! It's aliens! Oh well. Yes, folks, these things are well, not necessarily aliens. This may be science fiction, but we ain't that kind of science fiction. Trying to avoid these fuckers will be fun because luckily they take like one hit from the tinnitus. Ah. Anti-clockwork metamorphosis. The secret symbol left by Carol Runesmith Bergenworth. The twisted cross means metamorphosis. Rotated anti-clockwise, this rune boosts stamina. The discovery of blood made their dreams of evolution reality, metamorphosis, and the excesses and deviation that followed was only the beginning. Yep, basically, it'll boost our max stamina by a reasonable percent. I think that one will do 5% the second tier. One will do 10% and then 15% for the third tier. Anyway, there we go. We got a lot of Madman's knowledge. And that is important concerning these guys. There's never a clear answer on what they are, but we can. But once we get later on, we'll get a better idea of what they could be. Anyway, we can head back. Down here. And I'll meet your piggy. Don't mind if we kill you now. In. And Commander of the Truths. We have more mudmen! Ah, oh, we have a lake room. For that later. Okay, danger gone, we can look at the room. Yep, dissipating lake. Transcription of the right ones in human voices ripples like a watery reflection. This rune means lake, and those who memorize it enjoy reduced bolt damage. Specifically because it's the dissipating lake rune. Depending on the lake rune, depends on the type of damage reduced. Just saying. Yeah. There's one for Bolt, one for Fire, one for Physical, one for Arcane, and one for the whole kit and caboodle. I'm gonna say those aren't as good as the more specifically tailored ones, but still prove to be very useful overall. I don't know why we find the Bolt one here, though. There's no reason to use it, you know, once acquired, right now. Actually, I'm not sure... Really, apart from some of the bosses in the Chalice Dungeons, which I'll show off later, once I get this LP done. Apart from some of the Chalice Dungeon bosses, I really don't think there's many bosses or even areas in the main vanilla, in the main game, or even in the DLC where the reduction in Bolt damage is very necessary. Oh well. But if we come over here, we've unlocked the gate that we could have been on this side of earlier, but I missed it. Oof. Probably shouldn't have made that one, but... Anyway, here we get Clockwise Metamorphosis. Clockwise Metamorphosis boosts our health by, I think, 10, 15, then 20%. Now, it's always handy to summon someone extra for the upcoming boss fight. I usually just do one of the NPCs. You really only need one person, and all you have to... It's best to use the, NPC bosses, because they can take a hit better than a partner can. And that's really all you need them for in this boss fight, is just to sponge up some damage. If I really want to. Nah. I could summon a second person, but it would make the boss fight way too easy. There we go. Into the graveyard that is really big. Look at those gravestones. They're huge! Anyway, we have to fight the Nazgul, Shadows of Yharnam. You know, I don't know why I get those confused. It's not like they're completely the same or anything. Or sort of similar, it's not funny. But yes, one has a sword, katana thing. One just killed the Madara's twin. Freaking hell. Okay. He sponged up too much damage. Oh. As you can see, one has a candle. One has a fireball. Or one has a sword. One has a sword and candle. One has a fireball and tinnitus. Well, an electrified tinnitus. Trying to fight all three of them at the same time. Yeah, see, because two of them will try to run up to you. The one will try to spam you with fire. The one will spam a sword. And the one with the tinnitus tends to hang back and, you know. And we can see after the halfway point, the one with the sword gains a lot of range. The one with the candle basically enchants his blade. The one without a sword. Gains, nah, fuck. me retry that. Yeah, I didn't count on the other Madara's, the Madara's twin, the one I summoned, to die so easily. From the looks of it, what I could tell from out of the corner of the screen was that the one with the candle and the one with the Tenitris weapon cornered him and just kind of beat him up until he couldn't heal. Or beat him up and basically stunlocked him so he couldn't heal. Okay. I think I might throw in... Alright, yeah, the one time that shortcut, the shortcut we unlocked before would be handy is right here, because I can... that. And I can head in through the shortcut. But like I said, apart from, you know, actually dying from the boss, there's really no point to the shortcut. Since I don't want to fight that one. Not to do with the piggy. But you... Let's see. Alright, come here, piggy. Voila. Of time, I'm gonna go around the mudmen. You see, you can hit the piggy to burn himself. Environmental hazards, they hurt everyone. Just saying. But okay, since Madara's twin failed, I'll summon Henrik. Henrik is a hunter we have to kill first, I think, before we can summon him here. Because I didn't summon him when I first tried to play through, when I first tried to record this. But anyway, yes, his set we can wear. Actually, I have it, or I own it. I'm just not going to wear it. But yeah, it's if you help, you can help Eileen and kill him. You can help her kill him, and you fight him where Gascoin is. I must be able to initiate the fight, though, with the normal character I'm not playing with. This will go better. So far it is. All I need them to do is... Dude. Haha! He didn't get a chance to do his thing. Thank you. most of the time you can interrupt this guy with just attacking him, because most of his attacks do concern the fireball. There we go. Wait, when did the other one die? Oh, yeah. Anyway, we're done, and we got Blood Rapture, a room that really confuses what the fuck these bosses were. A terror room that transcribes inhuman sounds. Blood Rapture is the raw euphoria of the warmth of blood. Restores HP with visceral attacks, one of the darker hunter techniques. The room resonates with servants of the queen, carrier of the child of blood, who yearn for their queen's blood with little hope of requitement. From them, they found solace in Blood Rapture that serves as a surrogate for their desires. The reason that's so confusing is because there's two characters that, in this game, that could fall under queen and that have a child of blood, or desire a child of blood. So, I'm pretty sure it's one of the characters, but it, like I said, it's kind of ambiguous, so it could fall under both characters. But hey, we finished that. I actually have a recording of this now. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys visit me again soon. Yeah. Please like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends. If you feel like spending a few dollars, please donate to my Patreon. It'd be much appreciated. Thank you, everyone.
Everybody's looking for something.